Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Tamashi Rise of Yokai on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Tamashi Rise of Yokai and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Tamashi Rise of Yokai. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else my friends, to start we have to open our favorite web browser. We selected the one we prefer. Let's continue, going to this URL I'm highlighting in green. Now, you can see on the screen of the PC. You don't need to type that URL, because there's the link in the video description and as well in the first pinned comment. We ended up on this page on our own website of Usitility, where we get in-depth information on how to download and install Tamashi Rise of Yokai on PC. We search lower a tad and simply click on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on that link, we arrive here on the website of BlueStacks. No panic, it is just the Android emulator that we are going to use to get access to that game Tamashi Rise of Yokai on PC. As you can discover here we get a great deal of advantages of running that emulator. So we are on the way to start downloading the Tamashi Rise of Yokai by clicking on the button play on BlueStacks that you can visualize here in green. We then click on it. Of course, the download step takes no time at all. Here it is, this is the download. It's an executable file. The following step is to run the installer, so we need to click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow modifications to the computer. We have said yes. I minimize the web browser to start to see the installer better. The installation software is very simple. It is made up of two options, install and setup path. I am going to describe what setup path truly does. We simply click on it. And then we discover that we've got here the path where the emulator will be set up. If we would like to vary this directory we have got to click on the browse button, and therefore we select another directory and set up the emulator wherever we would like. I will set it where it is. I click on back. And therefore I pick install. Great. The install commences and it will continue together with the download of those MB that are shown on the screen. At the time you download it, it could be more or less MB. The download speed will go at a higher speed or at a lower speed, based on your internet and depending on the velocity of the emulator web servers. Right now they're progressing very fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this time, the emulator has actually been started instantly. As you can see now, at the bottom of the screen, we have a progress bar that will fill up so when it actually reaches the finish, the emulator will be started for the first time. Believe it or not, the emulator is already started, here it is for the first time. Before we continue on, as you understand, it created two icons right here on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon is the only one we are focused on. Each time we are planning to operate Tamashi Rise of Yokai on the desktop or laptop, we double-click that app icon and as a result launch the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let me make the next phase, that is a must, and that's to begin browsing the Google Play Store. And we'll mouse click on Play Store. As can be seen the Google Play is presented. At this point we need to sign in. Currently the moment we're there, we must begin doing the following step which is imperative. So we simply click on, Sign In. At present it announces, Checking Info. It might from time to time get stuck in, Checking Info, and this doesn't advance. In that case, you should attempt to log in after a few hours but it will surely most likely be solved. At present we shall provide our username and password. The email needs to be a Gmail email address and its associated password. For example, you could use the very same email you use currently in your own YouTube account. Therefore, I will submit my details and I will come back as soon as I have done it. Voila, information typed. This is Google welcoming us and offering us the terms of service. We should accept them all by hitting, I agree. Then, it allows us to back up to the Google Cloud. You could leave it checked and it'll build a backup of your data on this device to Google Drive. I won't select it, you can utilize that feature if you desire. We simply click on accept. The Google Play Store is started without need to open it manually and instantly. To install the app game, we must browse the emulator desktop by simply clicking on this icon designated in green. At this point that we are exploring the desktop of that emulator, we see that we now have right here the install application button. We then click on the button. On this page we access to the Android game. Why don't we click on there on the install option that I am just highlighting now in green color. This action will initiate the software setup. At this point it will download and install the game app. It may take quite some time or it might possibly be very quick. This all relies on our own connection to the internet. It has just ended setting up. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by simply clicking on this specific button that I am presenting in green, to be able to start Tamashi Rise of Yokai for the first time. I am at present on the emulator desktop, and so we are going to just click on that brand new Tamashi Rise of Yokai icon that was created. That Android game is started for the first time. There we get it, I'm able to press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to talk about the sound level of the emulator. It is here. We have got the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume. This way we do not depend on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the music of the emulator. And also to appreciate the experience to the greatest, we could turn on the big screen, for which we have two choices. This one is simply the very first one. We just click on this software icon that I'm pointing out in green color. Thus the display screen is maximized, experiencing one border at the top, one at the right and the last one at the bottom. If ever we aspire to play the video game in full screen, we press on this particular game icon. And we'd presently be enjoying the game in full screen setting. To quit the full screen functionality, press the F11 key. And we might currently be in normal computer screen mode. At this point, I am ready to explain you the computer keyboard mapping which is actually extremely enjoyable. This step we will be capable to make use of the video game much more effortlessly. The very first thing is to mouse click this software icon. It's now time to complete the required configurations. I'm going to keep the standard configuration, though if you want to modify that, you can also achieve it without having problem. As you can observe, the emulator is absolutely in our own language. In some cases it happens that the emulator is started in the improper language, for example, in Mandarin. And as a result to set it up in the appropriate language we go here to the cogwheel. So right here throughout additional settings, we just click on the language drop down. We may select the language we want, German, Chinese, and so on. After the language is selected, we should save, the emulator will reboot, and the Android game, next time we use it, would also be in the selected language. Right now, you will find another thing that we will need to take into account, and it's that we will receive an email saying that a completely new device has been linked to our own Google account. It should question us if we're the people who have connected that electronic device. Yup, we really should not worry, because the emulator is emulating an Android smartphone or tablet. And in order to identify which tablet or smartphone is being emulated, we arrive here, to the cogwheel and we simply click on it. Be sure to browse here to the model selection. And right here we discover that the emulator is acting as a Samsung mobile phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it guys, so much for our training. I hope you enjoyed it, particularly that everyone found it informative. If so, offer it a nice like, subscribe, and I will be happy to answer all your remarks, questions or ideas, put them in the comment area below. You can also comment things on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams on occasion, you have it listed below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Check out any of these online videos that are showing up on the listing of videos to watch and let's have fun again in the future video tutorials. Bye.